Hello, how are you, pupils? It is another day, and we are going to discuss something on geography. The last lesson, we were discussing on how to use topographical maps to identify what is known as the climatic zones or climatic areas, whereby within different pictures we have seen how when once you've been given a picture or a photograph, like I showed you the last time, indicate a specific climatic zone. Today we are going to look something very different, and it's very, very important as long as geography is concerned, standard 7. This is how we can use the lines of longitude to calculate time. I'm calculating time using longitude, so the lines of longitude. First of all, we have to understand, what are the longitudes? This one here, what is a longitude? The longitudes, you can say that these are the lines running from poles to poles. The lines running from North Pole to South Pole. The lines running from North Pole to South Pole. So this is what we call the lines of longitude. So when we are finding time of a given area, we normally use the lines of longitudes to find time. So what is the line of longitude? They run from North Pole to South Pole. This is the North Pole, and this is the South Pole. This is what we call the longitudes. These are the longitudes. And these lines of longitudes, they are divided at every 15 degrees. That means that at every 15 degrees covers 1/2. So that gives us a formula. So how can we use these lines of longitude? Let's say that this is 0 degrees, this is 15, this is 30, this is 45, and this is 60. The same to this side, this is 15, you can say this is 30, this is 45, and this is 60 degrees. This side is west, this side is what? East. So this means, that means that the lines are divided at every 15 what? Degrees. So let us come back to question number 1. What is the time in Accra, Ghana, which is 0 degrees if it is known at Dar es Salaam, 45 degrees? So to find the time, let's say that this is Accra, Ghana, and this is Dar es Salaam. And in Dar es Salaam, here we can say that it is noon. This is Dar es Salaam, where it is what? It is noon. Dar es Salaam, it is noon. We don't know the time at Accra, Ghana. So we want to use the lines of longitude to calculate time. Let me wrap first of all this one. So using the lines of longitude to calculate or identify time, we can say, we can just draw a timeline by just saying that this is 0 degrees, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. This is 15, 30, 45 degrees. This is east. This is 15, 30, this is 45 degrees. This is west. And therefore, we have been told that the Accra, Ghana is 00 degrees, and Dar es Salaam 45 degrees, which is the same as 12:00 noon. What's very important that you have to notice here is that when once you've been asked to calculate time using longitude and you are moving towards west, you are moving towards west, that means that you are coming from east towards west, we normally lose time. We lose time. But once you are moving from west to east, we normally gain. So this side we lose, this side what? We gain. We gain. So according to our question, as you can see, this person is here, and the person is going to move all the way from there up to 0 degrees. That means that this person will lose. So if here is 12:00 noon, when we move, and remember, our formula says that formula, this is very important, at every 1 hour covers the same as 15 what? Degrees. This is very important. Or you can say that at every 1 degree is equal to 4 minutes. The two things are very, very important when it comes to calculation of time using longitude. So according to the questions, the person is here. We want to move until we reach Accra, Ghana. This is where we have Ghana. So that means that we are going to move, when we move 1 hour here or 15 degrees here, it becomes 11:00 a.m. Because here it was noon, then you move 1 hour back. You lose 1 hour. When you lose 1 hour from 12:00 noon, that means that you come back to 11 a.m. From 11 a.m., we go to 10:00 a.m. From 10 a.m., now Accra, Ghana, it comes to 9:00 a.m. So the time at Ghana, Accra, Ghana, we call it Accra, Ghana, will be 9:00 a.m. That is final. That's how we can find what? We can find time. But this method, we can only use it if the digit or the degrees given is divisible or are divisible by 15. This is another method we can use to find the answer. But so it's saying that you group the data, you can just write data given, then you say that Dar es Salaam, we have been given 45 degrees, Ghana, we have been given 0 degrees. From here, we can change degrees into hours, because here, whether you add or subtract, there's a situation where we can add or subtract the degrees given. But in this situation, whether you add or you subtract, it will still remain the same. So what you do, you simply change this one, change degrees into hours. How can we change degrees into hours? We say that if 1 hour makes 15 degrees. What about 45 degrees? This 45 degrees here. So it will be 45 degrees times 1 hour. Remember here we do cross multiplication over 15 degrees. Here 1, here 3. So we get 3 hours. So that means that between Accra and Dar es Salaam, in between we have a difference of 3 hours. In between, you have a difference of 3 hours. And remember, the time at Dar es Salaam is 12:00 noon. So from 12:00 noon, you simply write 12:00 noon minus 3 good hours. When you subtract, the answer will be 9:00 a.m. So the same thing we have here is the same thing we have here. So there's two ways traffic, but the same answer. We can say two ways led to Rome, or all roads led to Rome, but the answer will be what? The same. So that's what we normally do. Question number two, because of time, we have a question which says that the time at Mogadishu, which is 30 degrees, is 6:45. Find the time at Mumbai, 60 degrees west. So Mogadishu is 30 degrees east. Let us write, or let us group the data. Hi. The time at Mogadishu is 30 degrees east. Let's say that here we have 0 degrees, 1, 2, 3. This is east, 1, 2, 3. This side is west. Then we have 15 degrees, 30 degrees, and let's say we have also 45 degrees, 15 degrees, 30 degrees. Can say 45 degrees, and here we have 60 degrees. This side is what? West. Let us come back to question. The time at Mogadishu, which is 30 degrees east. So here we have what? Mogadishu. Then we have been the time given is 6:45 a.m. What about find the time at Mumbai, 60 degrees west? This side is west. We don't know the time here. So this person will move all the way from 30 degrees up to until what? 60 degrees west. And remember what I told you the last time that when we are moving from, or we are moving from east towards the west, we lose time. So the same case here, we are going to lose time. The same case here, we are going to lose what? We are going to lose time. So that means that we are going to count. If here was 6:45 a.m., let us move up to 60 degrees. So if here is 6:45, what about here? It will be 5:45 a.m. Then from there, it will be 4:45 a.m. From there, it will be, let's say, 3:45 a.m. From there, it will be 2:45 a.m. And from there, it will be 1:45 a.m. And from there, it will be, from one, where do you go to? It will be 12:45. So here we want to identify, will it still be AM or PM? Because here now it will be 12:45, will it still be AM or PM? That's what we have to identify. That's what we have to know. Then from there, we can still say it is 12, that one what? AM, because when we come from 1:45 AM, then we go back to 12:45, it will still be what? AM. Therefore, let us see something here. If that's the first method we can use, what about the second method? The second method will be, we can say that data given. Then you say that we have Mumbai, which is 60 degrees west. Then we have Mogadishu, which is 30 degrees east. So because we have been given east and west, we normally add them. We normally add. So that means that we are going to add here, whereby we will get 90 degrees. Then change this one into hours. We see that if 1 hour is equal to 90 degrees. Sorry, if 1 hour is equal to 15 degrees, what about 90 degrees? We do cross multiplication by saying that 90 degrees times 1 hour over 15 degrees. 5 here 3 times, 5 here 1 times, 5 into 9 1 times, so it becomes something like 18. 3 here 1, 3 here 6. So this one plus this one, we get 6 what? 6 hours. We get 6 hours. So the difference is still 6 hours. Then because we are going to lose time, we come to the original time given, which was, we come to the original time given, which was this, 6:45. It was 6:45 a.m., sorry, 6:45 a.m. So from 6:45 a.m., we are supposed also to subtract 600 hours. So when we subtract 600 hours, when we subtract 600 hours from there, that means that we have this one, 45. Then here we are going to have 00. So once we have 00:45, our answer, it will still be AM, because it is like we are at the midnight. So once we are in the midnight, because midnight sometimes we write it like this, I hope you have noticed this. At exactly midnight, sometimes the time appears like this. It becomes 00 hours. That means that we are at the midnight. So even if we subtract here, this one, it becomes 00, but in the real sense, we can still write it like this, 12:00:45 a.m., to indicate that is all the what? The time, but in the real sense, it is midnight. And it is 45 minutes past midnight. Here we can say that it is 45 minutes past what? Midnight. And if it is 45 minutes past midnight, we can still consider it as AM. So, dear viewers, for today we have only seen when one is moving from east towards west and how we lose time. So the coming lesson we shall see on the way how. What if somebody is moving from west towards east? We normally gain time. And how can we get time? So from today, let us end here. But I would like to emphasize that once you are at home, continue revising. Check the papers that you are sent. Through those papers, we have questions, various questions concerning calculation of time using the lines of longitude. Continue doing more practice, because this is very, very important as long as the 7 examination is concerned. So I would like to wish you a good day. See you when you see me.